Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I remain Abdisalam Azoveh, your facilitator on ECN 411. Today we are going on study session 3, and the topic is traditional economic system. From our last study session, we discussed feudalism. We talked about the futures of feudalism, the merit and the demerit. We also discussed the lords, serf, vassals, kings, their functions, and so on. And today, like we stated, we are trying to connect to all the economic systems that have existed before the modern economic systems of capitalism, socialism, mixed economy, so on. So another of such economic system is the traditional economic system. By the end of this study session, learners should be able to explain the meaning of traditional economic system, discuss some of the key features of traditional economic system, give the advantages of traditional economic systems and the disadvantages of traditional economic systems. Topic 1, the meaning of traditional economic system. From the word traditional, our mind will already be going to the villages or the old systems as far as our mind can take us. Yes, you may not be far from the truth, because a traditional economy is a system that relies on customs, histories, and time-honored beliefs. A traditional economic system relies basically on the prolonged practices of a particular community. Some practices that have endured the test of time. Some customs that have endured the test of time. This is how our forefathers did it. This is how our great-great-great grandfathers did it. So this is how we are doing it. Traditional economic system uses tradition to guide economic decision. Remember, what we are interested in this course is to know how the decision of what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce is made. Who made the decision? In traditional economic system, such system uses tradition to guide economic decisions. They use tradition to determine what to produce, and they use tradition to determine for whom to produce. And they use tradition to determine the distributions, the allocation of resources. So, when you look at it, basically, the societies in tradition that uses traditional economic systems, they operate mainly on agriculture. They are usually agricultural-based economic systems, where things like hunting, fishing, gathering, wood gathering, and so on, are the major sustenance or the major economic activities that takes place there. So you have the agric practices, and the other one we have trade, and the form of trade we have in traditional economic system is basically the barter system of trade, where a farmer probably brings his yam in exchange of looking for who has a grass cutter from hunting that wish to exchange for yam. So these things happens in the traditional economic system. So there is agriculture and there is trade in the form of barter. So the traditional economic system has been on, and most economies can trace their background, their history, or most societies can trace their history back to the traditional economic system where all these things takes place. Now, what are the futures that are common to traditional economic system? How do you identify that, okay, this system now is a system in tradition or using traditional guide on decision makings? One of such future is that traditional economy is based on custom, like we have discussed, traditions and beliefs that has been there for long. This is the basic future of tradition, of traditional economic system. They basically depend on customs and beliefs. So, but you cannot mistake traditional economic system because of belief. You cannot mistake it for communalism. It's different. Because these beliefs might not be of religious belief that we're talking about. Not necessarily religious. But they have traditional belief system where certain things is believed to happen. How the rain fall, when the rain fall, how do we cultivate, where do you cultivate, where do you not cultivate, and so on and so forth. There are traditions that guide all of these things. Number two, a traditional economy is modeled on how a community actually lives, dependent on geography, culture, hierarchy, and the tradition. So, how the economy, how they live, it is not just about how they produce, how they farm, how they trade. It also encompasses how they live. So, the way they live enforces the kind of practices. Where they live determines the kind of practices that that you expect to see. The location, the geographical location where they live. And number three, a traditional economy is modeled upon age-old means of production, such as agriculture, fishing, hunting, and gathering. These are another peculiar picture, future of an economy in tradition. Then, number four, a traditional economy doesn't depend on a single currency. Instead, it relies on a system of barter and trade, exchange of goods and services. You don't have one single unit of exchange. Say, okay, like we do now. Then it's an issue of barter, trade by barter. It's as simple as that. That's why everybody is always working in traditional economic system, because you need to have something to offer in exchange for those things you do not have. So the hunter is always in the bush, the forest. The farmer is always in the farm. The women are always there gathering, looking for what to do, and so on and so forth. So that in the end, you have something to exchange for what you do not have or cannot make. They don't have money to exchange for all this what they have or what they do not have. The fifth future is that a traditional economy depends on the product and services produced to be fully used. Nothing is wasted in traditional economy. They believe whatever is being produced should be what is sufficient for a household or the community. There's nothing like you go about, you see oranges, you know, decay. No. If you have oranges that will decay, you use it to exchange for games that one hunter came with that he cannot consume all. You use it to exchange for other products others have produced that you do not have. So there is no wastage. Number five simply discusses no wastage as a future of traditional economy system. Then another future of a traditional economy system is that there could actually be a moving community, like a moving society that moves from one geographical area to another. An example is the Maasai tribe of Kenya, who have moved from one location to another, and they now share borders with some other countries in that place. But in the time, they were mobile. It's more like the Fulanese as well. They tend to move around with their cattle and so on. Then We have the Cro-Magnon people of the early United Kingdom. So these people, they also exhibit this kind of a geographical movement from place to place at the time. So these are the features of a traditional economic system that are traceable to every society from time in our past. Then, what are the advantages? What are the advantages that is obtainable from traditional economic system? Why was it good? Why did most economic survive through traditional system at the time? One of such reasons is collective responsibilities. Collective responsibilities. Traditional economies bring strong, tight-knit communities where every member plays a role in either generating or supporting the production of goods and services. Every member plays a role. Now, this can be a form of similarity to communalism in our study session one. Everybody has a role. So the same thing is obtainable in traditional economic system. Everybody plays a role in issue of production of goods and services, because you must have something to offer, and that is the truth. You must have something to offer, since exchange of good for good is the order of the day. You must have a good to offer in exchange of another good. Then another advantage is that there is well-defined rules in traditional economic society. Is well-defined rules. Now, every member of the society has been saddled with a particular responsibility, and they are all aware of what is at stake if they do not live up to their responsibilities. So everyone have a skill that they must build on. Everyone has a knowledge that they must develop. They have a role that they must play. So it is well defined. You know what you are to do. Then another, the third advantage is that it encourages clean and healthy environment. Now, this advantage is in relation to or in comparison to our modern day economic system, because some of the economic system at this present time are very dangerous and disastrous to the environment. But in the traditional economic system, there is healthy environment. There is no industrial pollution. There is no industrial pollution. And because the community or the economy only produces what they need, no need, there is no point producing excess that you now have waste that will litter everywhere. They only produces what they need from time to time. So there is no unhealthy environment. There is no dirty environment. There is no pollution of any kind. So these are peculiar advantages to traditional economic system. Then it also has its own disadvantages. It also has its own disadvantages. One of those disadvantages is that members have to work continuously without rest. Remember, they do not produce excess, and remember that everybody have to work. It's a collective responsibility where everybody has his own role. So they live every day at a time, every month at a time, every season at a time. Nobody is talking about what happened next season. We're talking about this season, so let's live this season. So every day you have to work for today. The hunter have to go to hunt for today. The farmer have to, those who are involved in gathering have to do their own for today. So if it goes to during the rainy season, the job might be different, but they will always be working. When the dry season comes, the job may be different. This time around, it may be the issue of, okay, drying those crops that were harvested, whatever they will use them for, grinding, all of those things, they will do. Hunting may change zone, but they will still be hunting, or may change pattern, they will still be hunting. So there is no vacation. It is work, work, work. Then the second disadvantage is that the economy is not entirely efficient. Traditional economy isn't as efficient as a market economy, which has a significantly stronger track record of success in guaranteeing a good quality of life for society. It's not entirely efficient, because in the market economy, you will see that there is interplay of forces of demand and supply. At the end of the day, the consumers ended up being ultimate beneficiary of the interplay. But in the traditional economy system, there's nothing like that. So you cannot really measure success, you cannot measure failure of the economy. The third is that there are very few career choices available for traditional economy. There are just very few career choices. From what we have been mentioning, if you listen back, you discover that they are just hunting, agriculture, and hunting, farming, and so on. Just few. So if you are at the time in a traditional economy system, your great grandfather is a farmer, the chance that your grandfather is going to be a farmer is high. The chance that your father will be a farmer, the chance that you will be a farmer, the chance that your child will be a farmer, the chance that your grandchildren will be a farmer is high. So there are very few career, as you say, disadvantage. So having looked at this, we can say that whatever has a good part have a bad part, but what we look out for in most cases is which part supersede the other. But the traditional economic system is fast going extinct, because there's very few places where you can see these practices, even in Nigeria at the time. So this brings us to the end of study session 3, and having successfully completed this study session, we have been able to learn the meaning of traditional economic system. We also have been able to learn to explain the key features of economy in tradition, or using traditional economic system. Then we did mention some of the advantages, three advantages of economic system and three disadvantages of traditional economic systems. So these are basically what we need to cover here. In our next study session, we may be looking at the economy of slavery. We may be looking at slavery as an economic system. Though it will come as a shock to many, but you will agree with me that at some point in the history of the world, some economies used slaves as a tool to enrich or to increase their productivity and enrich their country. So it's worth studying. We are going to discuss that in our next study session. But before we go, I will still leave you with one or two assignments to use to brainwash. Question one is to mention any two features of a traditional economic system. And question two is to mention two similarities between the traditional economic system and feudalism, which we did in your study session two. So thank you, and meet you in the next study session.